Hello there. Today I want to talk about the structure of the cathode ray oscilloscope. Behind me on the chart, I want you to follow me and then learn something out of it. So, the cathode ray oscilloscope is made up of three parts, or it is divided into three parts. It is divided into the electron gun, deflection system, fluorescent screen. Now, each of these has got its own smaller structures. Here we have the filament, the cathode, grid, and the anode. These four structures, they make what we call the electron gun. While the X-rays and the Y-rays, these two, they make what we call the deflection system. And then we find that the screen is made up of a substance which is called the fluorescent. No wonder it is called the fluorescent screen. Well, let's now talk about the functions of each of the parts of the cathode ray oscilloscope. To start with, the cathode ray oscilloscope is connected to the power supply. And we have seen these coils here. These coils, they are called the filament. So what will happen is, when the switch is closed, the power is going to be supplied to the filament. So the filament is going to grow. And as it grows, it is going to heat up the cathode rod. So when the cathode rod is heat, it is going now to start emitting electrons that are going to be moving in a beam. So as they move from, as it emits these electrons, we call this as the thermionic emission. Why? Because thermionic emission simply means the process by which a hot surface emits electrons. Apart from that, when the electrons are emitted, they are going to pass through a grid. Now, I want us to look at one of the parts of the human eye, which is responsible in controlling the amount of light entering the eye. Well, under the oscilloscope here, a grid also performs the same functions, but in a different way. Here, the grid is responsible in controlling the amount of electrons passing through it. As the electrons continue passing, as the electrons continue passing, they will reach the part which is called the anode. Under the anode, we can now simply say that the flowing of electrons from the cathode to the anode is what we are calling cathode ray. Now, under the cathode itself, its function is to make sure that it focuses the electrons and also makes the electrons to be splayed on the screen. So its function is to focus the electrons on the screen. Just like the lens in the human eye is responsible in focusing the image of or light rays on the retina so that the image is formed. Away from that, we have the Y plates. When the beam of light reaches the Y plate, the Y plate will deflect these rays up and down, up or down. And as the ray of light are deflecting up or down, they will reach this the X plates. In the X plates, that's where we find that the function of the X plates is to deflect the beam of light left or right, and then further focus them on the screen. Now, if you are standing in front of the TV screen, you will find that when you are switching the TV screen at the first, in the morning or whatever time you are switching the TV screen, the first thing you are going to see are some of the spots that will be speeding or moving up and down like droplets of rains. So as they do so, those are what we call electrons, and those electrons are going to cause the screen to be lightened up, and then you will see the objects or images of different people around appearing on the screen. Well, I hope you have enjoyed the lesson, and I promise to bring you another interesting video that is going to be talking about the uses of the oscilloscope and also a bit of some calculations. All you need to do is to stick to me, and also make sure that each time I'm live or I post something on my tube, especially my Facebook tube page and also my YouTube, you'll be able to be the first one to like it. So all what you need to do is to subscribe and also click on the bell so that each time I'm live or I upload the video, you'll be the first person to get the notification. Otherwise, thank you very much for your time, and we'll continue interacting.